Today our topic is pathophysiology of the heart. First of all, how congestive heart failure occur? Congestive heart failure occur due to the damage or the weakening of the heart muscles. Why weakening or the damage of heart muscle occur? Because there are two reasons for that. That is due to coronary artery diseases, that is due to clogged arteries or the fatty deposition in the heart arteries. And the other one is hypertension, that is chronic long-term hypertension. Chronic hypertension. What happened in congestive heart failure? Number one. First of all, stroke volume decreases in congestive heart failure. And the other one is decrease in cardiac output. Decrease in cardiac output. What is stroke volume? Stroke volume is the amount of blood pumped by the heart per beat. And what is cardiac output? It is the amount of blood pumped by the heart per minute. It is the amount of blood pumped by the heart per minute. Now, when there is low stroke volume or the less cardiac output, heart try to compensate this. How heart try to compensate? Heart try to compensate it through structural changes. Compensation comes at a cost of structural changes. And what happened? Dilated cardiomyopathy or hypertrophic cardiomyopathy occur. What happened in dilated cardiomyopathy? In dilated cardiomyopathy, there is a thinning of the ventricle walls due to which there is a bigger space for the blood, but due to this thinning of the ventricle, what happened? The pumping ability of the heart decreases. Pumping ability of the heart automatically decreases. Now, number second is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. What happened in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy? There is a thickening of the walls of the ventricles due to which these walls become stiffer. And what happened then? There is less room for the blood. So automatically stroke volume decreases. And it is the cause of the heart failure. Now these are the structural changes in heart. Now we are moving towards kidneys. Kidneys need a lot of blood for their working. So when there is less blood, kidneys become angry. They release renin in response, which release angiotensin, which in turn release aldosterone. They stimulate each other. Angiotensin stimulate aldosterone hormone, which retain salt and water. Due to this fluid accumulation or retention, there is increase in BP. Long-term BP leads to CHF, congestive heart failure, or the congestive cardiac failure. Now we are moving towards failure of the heart. There are two types of failure, left side failure and the right side failure. Left side heart failure and right side heart. If left side of the heart fails first, what happened? There will be pulmonary edema. There will be pulmonary edema. And if the right side of the heart fails first, pulmonary edema, what happened in pulmonary edema? There is the fluid retention in the lungs. And what happened if the right side of the heart fails first? There will be jugular vein distinction or swelling of ankles. Swelling of ankles. This is the pathophysiology of the heart. Now we are looking towards summary. Pathophysiology of the heart. What happened in congestive heart failure? There is damage or weakening of the heart muscle due to coronary artery diseases or hypertension, due to which there is decrease in stroke volume and the cardiac output. For this, heart try to compensate this stroke volume and cardiac output. Structural changes occur in heart, which leads to the CHF, and kidneys also become angry and they release renin, which stimulate angiotensin, which in turn stimulate aldosterone, which retain salt and water, and hence increase in BP, and hypertension occur, which leads to CHF. There are two types of heart failure. If left side of the heart fails first, then pulmonary edema occur, and if right side of the heart fails first, then jugular vein distinction and the swelling of ankles or ascites may occur.